Hi, welcome to TREBONS. So we're with Grace and her puppies, and they should only be a few days old now. Shortly after we did our health check on Grace, which went perfectly well, and did x-rays and ultrasound to see how many puppies we had and that everything was okay, she gave birth and started her labour. And this is on day 54, day 55, rather than day 62, day 61 sort of thing. And so it was a bit of a surprise. She gave birth to a puppy and it was dead. You can see it had a bit of necrosis, black. And then it's a case of, you know, okay, maybe you've lost the whole litter and you had to get down to the vet. They could all be dead, etc. So down to the vet for a cesarean. And we've had a cesarean before. That was at full term, when there was actually a problem in delivery. This time it was very, very different. and the puppies that were coming out weren't really there, if you know what I mean. When we've done it before, they've been full-size puppies. You pull them out and 5 seconds later, they're up there breathing and everything else. This time it was a big, big struggle to get them moving, to get them to take a breath. And she had a big litter. And basically, any puppy under 240 grams never took a breath. Those over 240, we could suscitate. And cut a long story short, at the end of the day, we left with 6 puppies. That's what we left with. One of the puppies was sort of on the edge and died that night. The rest seemed pretty reasonable and everything else, but we're sort of left with a dilemma. What do we do? Do we go straight onto formula? Now the puppies weighed from 290 down to 240 grams, 290 to 240 grams. And because we don't want the female to dry up, we decided to milk Grace. But the second reason we decided to milk Grace and feed them with Grace's milk rather than go straight to formula was also because of the immune system. The mother passes antibodies across to the puppies for their immune system in that initial period, and it's very, very important. Nothing wrong with the formulas, but nothing beats the mother's milk. It's custom made for those puppies. So that's what we decided to do. And tubing, and these were small puppies, their heads were not much bigger than my finger, and I'm not exactly very dexterous, in fact I'm quite clumsy, so that was a bit of a challenge with that, but we managed. All is far more capable of that sort of stuff than I am, you should see me, and but we managed with that. That was all going well, and the first day, basically, that we managed to keep the same weight. Didn't really lose any weight. That was on the Sunday. On the Monday, we started to lose weight and introduced the formula, and despite that, we were still losing weight out of the puppies. On Tuesday, the weight loss stopped, but we weren't putting any weight on as such. And all in all, the puppies lost about 10 grams. We managed to stem the weight loss, and we were just treading water, basically. They weren't putting weight on as such, but they weren't losing any. But the reality is that every day they're older, they should have put on weight, so they're actually, in reality, losing weight all the time. And then you got dehydration as well. We had to keep the bed very, very hot, and they got dehydration, and that was a problem right from the beginning, really. Not only are they not eating or drinking as much as they should, they're also getting dehydrated. So that was a huge problem. Wednesday, the weight loss actually managed to get a couple of grams onto the puppies, and by Wednesday evening, we were back to where we were. At the beginning, they basically gained their birth weight. So still treading water. Then Wednesday night, Thursday morning, and all in between all that, we've been feeding every 2 hours. So it's not like they weren't offered it or we can get it down there. That's all we can do. and we were using formula then and topping up with Grace's milk as well to make sure she didn't dry up. But Wednesday night, Thursday morning, they started sucking, and that was quite a remarkable experience to see, because it was like these empty sacks, because that's what they were. They're very, very fragile, and there's not much to them. They just started inflating, and literally you saw it in front of you, and it's like suddenly all this loose, wrinkly skin just started filling out. And that was pretty amazing to watch and see. So, but as I said, we actually lost a puppy on the Monday, the second puppy we lost, and that was, as I say, about fragile. You've seen in previous videos when we've had puppies and the mother's cleaning them and looking after them on the first day, and they're actually quite, you know, they're pushing them around, they're quite, well, I wouldn't say rough, but the puppies are pretty durable and pretty elastic, really. And there's nothing in a premature puppy. They actually have no instinct whatsoever. The only thing they can do is move for the warmth. They don't make a sound. When they're hungry, they don't make any noise whatsoever. They can't suck. There's just nothing to them. The only thing they can do is move for warmth. And we had the lights on and everything else, and mats in their bed. But I'd just finished feeding a puppy, and I put it down for Grace to clean, as you normally do. Say, take this one here. Woof, woof, woof. And I put it down in front of Grace, something like that. And Grace, all she did was put up a paw on the puppy and started cleaning. And it was just too much for the puppy. It never recovered from it and died. That's just how fragile they were. And it's something we were certainly not used to. And of course the mother's not used to either, because she doesn't realise they're premature. So she's treating them exactly the same way as she would any other puppy. And you don't realise there's just no give. You have nothing to play with. But as you can see now, they're doing really, really well. And basically since Thursday, I mean, today is Wednesday, so they're just sticking on the weight like nobody's business. I'm going to take you off the tip. I know it's something we haven't done before, so this is a new experience. Oh, and we're glued on there. But I mean, he's a big fella, and he was 290 when he was born, and a week ago he was 290, and we managed to keep him at that weight. And today he is 960, 965 grams. So he's just about okay, but that weight has only gone on in a week, from 290 up to that. It's just incredible to see the progress that's been made. I'm very happy with them all. They're all putting on weight, and they're all putting in, gaining the weight at the same rate now. So they're all pretty big. Up there in the 800s now, I think. So we seem to be on the right side of things now. Grace is doing fine. I don't know what you're in for, do you? So, yeah, and we'll keep following the litter. We'll start our exercises now that we've got this all under control. And, yeah, we'll follow the litter and see how they do.